thanks for tuning in. My name is Benjamin Kegele. I'm showing you today my brand new or 3 months old Ford Mustang Mach-E 2021. It is the premium standard range in rapid red. It's like the same like you see from the ad or from the NASCAR. It is premium edition, which means it has a sunroof and it has the better audio system and some knickknacks which the select version doesn't have. First of all, I want to open the hood and show you what is under the hood, because you will be probably surprised if you haven't seen a Mach-E yet. There is not much in there. I can show you there is a beautiful ice chest full of snacks for all the visitors at the virtual car show. Water, beer, chips, soda, whatever you want. There's not much else under the hood except a 12 volt battery. Even EV needs a 12 volt battery, which is kind of funny. But then here you see the rims. Every version of Mach-E has a different rim. The badge tells you which version it is. So it is the Mach-E. It's not the extended range. It is not the four-wheel drive. Then I want to go and show you a little bit to the inside. First, let's go around the front door. You see there's no proper door handle except that little hook. I got the white interior. White is really beautiful, easy to maintain, just wipe it off. The black trims on the door and around is kind of harder to clean than the white trim. Then when you go to the trunk, you see the trunk is spacious. Fits a lot of things in there, especially for me. I have a little family. I could never drive a regular Mustang because they don't fit in there. Here I can fit everyone easy on the rear seat and all their knickknacks in the trunk. If I sit in the rear seat with my 5'9", I have plenty of space. I still got like 2, 3, 4 inch in front of me, depending how big the guy in front of me is. You can fold down the entire seat if you got a haul some cargo. The center console has no drivetrain underneath, which means the floor is flat everywhere inside and has a lot of storage capacity under the armrest or under the display. As you can see, there's like 2 storage area. The door frame shows Mustang, the door mat shows Mach-E. A lot of little details, I love it. Then you see it has a regular gear shifter, it has a huge display. I got the sunroof. And I put a little blackout in it so to keep the heat and light out. I hope it helps in this hot summer nights and summer days. Then let me show you also a little bit the display, how it works. It has the 2 displays. One is in front of the steering wheel. The one in front of the steering wheel shows you the speed and also the range and also like regular error codes like door open or engine codes or whatever. Hope I never get one because I don't have an engine. Then the big display can be used for Android Auto, Apple CarPlay, to adjust your AC, to adjust the radio stations, to find EV chargers, or you can even project apps to it. If you go to the main menu, you will see there is already plenty function built in, like, and then you connect to Android Auto, you can play your music, or you open Google Maps or Waze, whatever you like. You can even listen music to Spotify or to other apps. Then you can open some apps to find a charger or use the built-in app, which also shows you where the next charger is, because they're not always easy to find as a gas station. Then next I want to show you a few photos which I shot, because I really like to make some great shots, like at night or during dawn or on a river, in the park, in the lake. I kind of, every time I look back at the car, I have to take a shot of it, so you see plenty of pictures. And everybody asks, how is the performance? Instant torque, you take off and you have a fake engine noise. If you want it, you can turn it on. I usually drive now without it because I got used to it, the quietness. If you like the fake engine noise, just turn it on. Here, second one, 0 to 60 with fake engine noise. It is quick. Of course, a GT will be probably much faster. Here, one from the dash, you see how it immediately drifts off. and you are at your 60 without even looking at it. Then here again, 0 to 60, front view from the dash cam. It is quick, I love it. Probably the fastest car I ever owned so far. I have one more drift from the rear view. And then I have one more little clip and my virtual car show will be over. See, last 0 to 60. So I really hope you enjoyed this video. If you want more or have any question, contact me and have a good day. Thank you very much. Bye bye.